Where's that damn fourth shadow episode? Oh, I'm in it, aren't I? Right, I knew that. Talk about the Switch a lot in this episode. I sure wish I could switch to a different LP.
Hello everybody, VG Shine here, and welcome back to Let's Play Sonic 2006. In the last episode, we traveled into the future because of Methylist. We found a Chaos Emerald, so that's cool, right? And now in this episode, we are gonna team up with Sonic to find the second Chaos Emerald that we need to travel back to the present, because, well, that's what the Chaos Emeralds do now in this game. So yeah, let's not waste any more time. Let's get right to it.
My precious Chaos Emerald, you are also beautiful.
Insert obligatory Gollum joke here. It's Omega.
Omega?
The Team Dark is finally complete once again. Yeah, we're Shadow Heroes!
It seems he's in standby mode.
Aww.
Well, what could have possibly happened to create this future? Yes, this is Rouge.
How is Gunn contacting her right now? That doesn't make any sense.
It looks like Sonic and his friends.
Oh, that was Sonic. Okay, that makes more sense.
It's not like we can do anything for him now.
Wait, how is Tails contacting her exactly? Yeah. Since when did he have a phone? That doesn't make any sense.
You guys are so slow.
You're too slow.
A Chaos Emerald. You've already found one.
Yeah, when did we find it exactly?
I may not look it, but I'm a real treasure hunter. Unlike a certain echidna I know.
What?
Oh, you do not make fun of Knuckles' ability to track treasure.
Indicating there's a Chaos Emerald here, but...
You mean we've got to go through there?
If you don't like it, you can stay here.
You've got to be kidding.
I love how they basically repeated the same animations they did in the previous scene. You know when Rouge made fun of Knuckles' treasure hunting skills. Anyway, this is the Flame Core stage. Alright, so after this, and possibly a boss, we will no longer have to do any future stages. So yeah, let's get the stage over with so we never have to deal with Michael Bay ever again. So yeah, last night was a really fun night for me and my friend Michael. We went to the Nintendo Switch event they had in San Francisco. Yeah, but yeah, like I said before, I was invited to the exclusive Friday or Saturday showing. So Sunday is like a public showing, which I believe my friend Metal Smasher 86 is going to, which is tomorrow from the time of this recording. Yeah, I'm thinking of like starting like a discussion video with me, my friend Michael, and Metal Smasher, like after he's done experiencing the Switch himself. I'm not sure how well that's gonna go. I mean, I've never actually done a discussion video before. Like a lot of like. I've only been part of like one discussion video, and that's like when I did one with Sensei Josh when we discussed like the Nintendo presentation on back in January, so I'll have a card so you can check out that discussion in case you're curious about it. But yeah, I've never actually done a discussion video myself. I'm gonna have to ask Metal Smasher to see if he'd be down for it. I'm not even sure when we'd be able to do it. I mean, we basically have to do it before the Switch comes out, otherwise, what's really the point? Anyway, we are here at this, we are here in the flame car, it's basically like the same as a Sonic stage, except we're playing as Shadow. Oh boy. So yeah, we gotta punch enemies, we gotta build a way forward and then punch more enemies. I'm assuming you've seen every other part by before this one, so you get the gist of how each and every stage functions. And you know, actually, I never tried out like Shadow's like a Chaos powers. I should try doing that right now. Okay. All right. Seriously, what's different? And yeah, right now all I've been doing is homing attacking. I've never really tried like using his Chaos powers. Judging by what's going on, I can see why I don't really use it because, well, it doesn't really work that. Oh, am I teleporting right now? I mean, I know I'm like in Chaos mode. Is that what this entails? I don't know. I mean, I'm basically warping everywhere, so I'm guessing that's one of the advantages of like, for future reference, I'm just gonna call this like Shadow's Kale Ken attack. Cause yeah, he's growing red, or Super Shadow God, whatever you're most comfortable with, doesn't really matter to me. Okay, so. So yeah, I am planning to release some Switch content videos tomorrow. In fact, they should already be up by the time you're watching this video, and I'll have a link to the playlist. Assuming, of course, I remember to do that, which usually I end up forgetting simple things like adding thumbnails or important links. In fact, there are a few important links for this series that I haven't been doing lately, linking to the guy who made the ending title card song. I should probably get right on that before I get in trouble, because the thing about YouTube is you gotta credit your sources or else you can get in trouble and possibly have your videos pulled. Yep. Okay, so Switch event. First off, me and Michael started with Breath of the Wild because, yeah, I wasn't really planning on playing Breath of the Wild, but Michael wanted to play it, and I was with him, so yeah, I got to play Breath of the Wild again. And yeah, this time I decided to just focus on the main quest instead of doing my own thing. I got to the beginning of the first mini dungeon, and I was about to try out like the magnet power, but then at that point I ran out of time. I was disappointed, but yeah, Breath of the Wild, awesome game. I'm definitely gonna do a video on it. Although I'm not sure if I'll be able to do that on launch day anymore. Like, I recently got an email from Amazon stating that the Wii U version might not be able to get to me on launch day. I don't know if I mentioned this before, but like I basically pre-ordered like both the Wii U version and the Switch version. The Wii U version I got on Amazon, and I'm an Amazon Prime member, so I thought for sure I would get that on launch day, but that might no longer be the case. And then for the Switch version, I managed to pre-order the special edition at the GameStop, but I was stupid and did not do the one day shipping, and 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 it's too late for me to change that, so yeah. Probably not gonna get to like after the weekend, and uh-oh. Okay, can I save myself? Okay, cool. We saved ourselves. Because we're awesome. But we're all out of bling, so we're kind of in big trouble here! No. You stay away! Okay. We're good. We're surviving. We're a survivor. Wow! Are you kidding me? Random debris killed me! Dang it! Yeah, screw you, random debris. I got bling. And now I'm gonna go inside the volcano. For no reason. Okay, so anyway, like, after our Breath of the Wild session was done, me and Michael decided to go right to, like, Puyo Puyo Tetris. And we basically versed each other in, two modes. The first mode was like, swap mode, where we basically swap between, Tetris and, Puyo Puyo, or basically, the Dr. Robotnik's Mean Bean Machine game. At least in American terms. Anyway, I managed to beat Michael on like both games because, well, I'm awesome. And the other, like, because like each match was like best of three, and I beat him two times in a row. And also we played the mix mode where you play the same board with both Puyo Puyo and Tetris, and it was honestly, it's kind of surreal, kind of weird. Like you play, you have the Tetris pieces and the Puyo Puyo pieces at the same time. And what's interesting about it is that the Tetris blocks, you can actually use those to crush the Puyo Puyo pieces. So you basically can. So yeah, that's basically part of the strategy. Like if you have too much goon away, then you can like crush it with a block. And yeah, let's make that a VG Shine Pro tip just because I can. Anyway, right. So right now in this game, we have these purple balls again, and I'm guessing we have to light them. Like, we were able to destroy them with silver, but ultimately, I guess we didn't really need to do anything with them. I mean, at Sonic, we had to, like, activate them all with Knuckles. I'm not sure what the story is with Shadow. Hopefully, this will not be as tedious. I mean, we got these purple enemies, which is obviously stronger than the normal red enemies. Yep. V-Shine pro tip, purple is stronger than red. Come on. Where am I supposed to... Wow. Yeah, Shadow don't give a crap. He can just dash right through your bullets, because he's so cool and awesome. Where do I go? Do I go to that door? Well, there's a switch, so I guess that's it. Yep. Just wait for the door to open. Yep. Even Shadow acknowledges just how BS these stages are because they take so freaking long. Okay, so and then after Puyo Puyo, what did we do next? Oh yeah, I think after that I went on my own and tried out Mario. Basically Mario Kart Deluxe, and in this stage they had like four different demos, demonstrating like the four different ways you can play your Nintendo Switch. I guess I'll start with the varieties I didn't get to play. Like so they had like one scenario where you're at a plane and you have the Switch in the tabletop mode. Like, but you know, when you're on a plane, you have the seat in front of you. You can like pull out a tray and you can like use it to eat food and stuff. And yeah, you had the Switch in tabletop mode, and then you were using like the Joy-Cons, like just like holding one in each hand and playing the game that way. And I think like each player is like by plane by themselves. Although I can imagine you can, like, when you're on a plane, you can, like, give the stranger, like, next to you your, like, your second Joy-Con. You can just play a quick two-player game that way. And another one they had was, like, you're at a diner and everybody has their own Switch in handheld mode, and they were playing multiplayer. And yeah, that's basically demonstrating, like, if, hey, basically you can play it like you did with the 3DS. And I just noticed that I have to activate all these purple balls like Knuckles did. Are you kidding me? Yep, right now, Nintendo Switch is the only thing keeping me sane right now. So, I gotta keep talking about it or else I'm gonna go insane. I mean, actually, I think I might already be insane. Let me know in the comments, am I insane yet? I mean, do you know what it takes to be insane? Okay, so... I'm trying to remember, like, which other configuration they had. I mean, they had the handheld, there was the airplane demo and tabletop mode. There's this diner demo. The one I played was the TV mode where you had like the Switch docked and you're both playing with your own controllers. Although actually for that demo, they had us like use these miniature steering wheel peripherals with each Joy-Con attached to them. You know, basically like the Wii wheel, except you have like Joy-Cons instead of Wii remotes. And I basically played battle mode with like one other person. And I'll have a link to that video in case, and like if you want to check that out. And Honestly, the Joy-Con wheel peripheral, like that control scheme, actually works pretty well. Like, I mean, I mean, you might notice like in the video I didn't perform as well, but honestly, that was mostly because I just wasn't used to that control scheme. In actuality, it works very well. I just needed to get used to it more. Like, if I had one or two more stages to practice, I could at least almost be as good at that control scheme as I do with like the normal controls. Because yeah, like at no point did I feel like it wasn't responsive. It was definitely responsive. I just, like I said, I wasn't used to the like that particular control scheme yet. So yeah, I'm basically admitting that any mistakes made were my mistakes and not because of like motion controls, because yeah, the motion controls definitely do work. I just gotta get used to them. Oh boy. And I'm trying to remember what the fourth like Mario Kart demo was. I'll look over the video and I guess I'll have like a text description of that. But yeah. Let's see, moving on. And I guess while I was doing that, Michael was playing Sonic Mania with one of the Joy-Cons on their sides. And I'm out of bling and the door still isn't open. What am I supposed to do? Like, what am I missing? Ah, come on. Please tell me you're just blinging these boxes. There's no bling in these boxes. Oh, yes, bling. Thank you. And no, please don't lose your bling now. Like after you literally just got it, that would be bad. Losing bling is bad. Okay. Oh boy. Yeah, I think I better just take care of all the enemies now and then focus on opening the door. Yeah. Yep, I am definitely gonna have to cut this segment out until I actually make it. Okay, so yeah, all you had to do is like get all the purple orbs. Like, Yeah, so far this is basically exactly like Sonic Stage, except we're playing with Shadow. I believe I already said that, but that Rouge segment basically already confirmed it. So, yeah, I don't know how much of this stage is left. So, yeah, so like I was saying, Michael was playing Sonic Mania. Anyway, Michael was playing Sonic Mania with like one of the Joy-Cons, and then after his turn, I'd had a go, and we both agreed that the Joy-Cons, despite how small it is, actually feels very comfortable. Like, I wouldn't if I had to use that as a controller when I'm playing with friends, I would not mind that because it's actually very. It's actually a very nice controller to use. I mean, you wouldn't think so because of how small it is, but yeah, that was the case, and okay, that was a weird animation there, but anyway, there's the goal ring. We made it! Ooh, boy. Yes! Okay, 23 minutes. I think I can call that an episode. So, join us next time. When we take on the Michael Bay boss, which there's no doubt in my mind that that's what's coming up next. So yeah, join me next time. Bye bye.